Yo, how's it going? Welcome. Yo is the new catchphrase of yo-yo. Yo, nickname for SashaKai. You see, the first Kai is yo-yo. So SashaKai, since she's the second Kai, has got to be yo-yo-yo. Now, ooh, sorry, baby. Some of you might be wondering why I'm inside wearing inside out, clearly a winter hat, right? When it's, June 3rd or June 4th or something? Well, that's to make a point, you see. I'm expressing my individuality, alright? My uniqueness. And, I'm sorry, I forgot to mention we have a sponsor for this program, which is going to be episode 1 of the Yo-Yo-Yo show, which is Kai's show, or SashaKai's show. SashaKai. You're SashaKai, right? Kai the second, Yo-Yo-Yo, you know, same thing. Ooh, sorry, baby. Alright, it's bisphenol A. I don't know what it is, BPA they call it. Some chemical, but chemicals are good, right? I mean, you know, they like treat infection or something. I don't know, somebody put in plastic too, I guess. We drink it, I don't know. Anyway, it's a sponsor, so buy some BPA. It's not to be confused with BMG, which is, you know, they send you that stuff in the mail to buy music and stuff, you know? You gotta like buy like 10, or no, you gotta buy like one and you get like 50 like CDs free or something, but then the one CD you buy is like, you know, $600 or something when you count the shipping and the tax and the surcharge and the custom fees and all that stuff. So one of those scams. Anyway, what we're gonna do is Yo-Yo-Yo wants to come out with something, a big announcement that she actually is a stage double, not really a stage double, a singing double for one of the famous singers of our generation. No, not Justin Bieber, and I'm not trying to do anything with the hair to indicate that. Believe me, just gotta get it cut, you know, someday. But somebody even bigger than Justin Bieber. You say, who's bigger than Justin Bieber? Yeah, one person. Who is that? You want to announce it or should I? Okay, I'll announce it. Lady Gaga. Of course. You know? And recently, she did a rendition of, what was the song? Edge of Glory. Sorry, I should know that, right? An acoustic piano rendition of it. It's one of the big hits, of course, you know that, and the Bounce on the Pogo Stick one. I like that one. But, yeah, you know, Edge of Glory, very moving song. And this rendition was only performed once on a certain radio talk show, okay? And everybody thought it was her, but see, it's radio. So you don't really know what you're getting, you know, because you're not really seeing what, you know, you're just hearing. But actually, she called in sick that day, and her singing double, Yo-Yo-Yo, I think we showed in the one episode before, she knows how to sing. She's got some pipes. And she also does an excellent imitation of Lady Gaga. I mean, you cannot tell if it's Lady Gaga you're hearing or if it's Yo-Yo-Yo. So, what we're gonna do is I'm gonna actually show you, there was actually behind the stage, or not behind the stage, but they actually had a video camera in there, I don't know, maybe a security camera or something, during the taping of this certain radio program, and Yo-Yo-Yo was actually, so I'm gonna show you the visual evidence that it was Yo-Yo-Yo who actually performed this rendition, and not Lady Gaga. Although she could have done it too, you know? but she had, I don't know, case of laryngitis or what's that other thing that's going around? I don't know, typhoid fever or something like that. Or was it Legionnaire's disease? I don't know, something like that. Maybe just herpes. But it was, she just wasn't feeling well, you know, under the weather. But it's a great song, you know. And Yo-Yo was like marvelous. And that's why you haven't seen it since, because she's not even sure if she can top, you know, because she's kind of modest and, you know, so she's not really sure if she can top it. But, you know, so that's why you haven't heard it since. And it's not going to be, maybe when they release like the next Fartman album or something, it might be on there. But anyway, oh yeah, before we do this, I wanted to bring your attention, the world's attention, to her foundation, because she wanted us to mention that. And I said, well, you know, it's fair. Yay. She's being kind of modest too. She don't mean the spotlight, but yeah, the Reborn This Way Foundation. I don't know what it's about. You know, I haven't really studied it, but I'm sure it's a great foundation because it's got the motto that I've always, you know, expressed from day one. So I think we got like a synergy there, you know, empowering youth, or you can be old. I mean, you can be, I don't know why she restricts it to youth, but I mean, maybe there's like an empowering old people, you know, old farts foundation too. Maybe it's, you know, Dead This Way Foundation, or soon to be Dead This Way Foundation. Anyway, this is about youth, because I guess youth, you know, of today are going to become like people who lead the country tomorrow, or lead the revolution tomorrow. I don't know, something like that. And the big thing, inspiring bravery, you know, so empowering youth, inspiring bravery. Those are great things, you know. Reborn This Way Foundation, it's kind of like those, you know, Scientology, you know, Christian scientist nutbags out there who do that, you know, reverginization thing, or, you know, being reborn in their virgination of, I don't know, something. Like, you can become a virgin again, you know, but those Scientology people, you know, I don't know, I think it's all Christians, I think, now believe it. Like, what's the big deal, you know? Come on, I mean, you know, move on, right? Who wants to stay a virgin anyway? I mean, please. It's not really hip these days, you know? Anyway, but you are one, right? Yes. You're saving yourself for, I don't know. Well, you're a dog, you know, but a beautiful dog. Yes. So, but for humans, you know, it's not really. Anyway, we don't want a litter of you running around, because you and your vet bills. You know what? She had an injured trachea, you know? Almost lacerated, actually, because she doesn't like leashes, we found out. So, yeah, but she can still sing her ass off. So, anyway, without further ado, let's, you know, show you the proof, right? All right, you want to do that, baby? Oh, and afterwards, we got a little treat for you, too. We're doing our third world country exotic getaway package. Or no, it's not a package, because we are actually going on it. Yeah, we're going on a third world getaway paradise, including countries like Laos, you know, Vietnam, Mongolia, Tonga, all the great places, you know, Zimbabwe, a few of the places like that, you know, Cambodia, you know, all the, see, third world countries, people think, at first glance, because they hear all the media hype, I don't want to go there. Well, you know what? People, the Caribbean, you know, the Palmas, St. Lauderdale, what is it? Fort Lauderdale, yeah, you know, spring break, all that, well, whatever. You know, all you vacationers, all you college kids, you know, going on spring break, whenever spring is, which isn't for a while, but, you know, think of this. Think of the third world nation getaway, okay? Because, for one, these third world countries aren't going to be around much longer because, you know, NATO is going to bomb the shit out of them for some reason. You know, human rights violations and all that kind of stuff. So they're not going to be around for that much longer. And you want excitement? Look, beaches are boring, right? You know, sandy beaches, palm trees, boring, you know? The waves, I mean, they do the same thing. They splash on the shore and, you know, boring, dull. Come on, people. So anyway, we are going to show you the most exciting getaway package that we put together. We're going to go on. When are we going on this thing? Well, we're actually going with a whole group. I think, I don't know, sometime July 10th, I think is when we leave. So it's going to be a really, really fun time. It's a ways away, but actually just about a month away. But we are getting packed, and the best thing is you can pack light. You know, you just got to bring your AK-47 or some kind of assault rifle. And the rest, you know, I mean, you can forget about, because everything else that you would need is provided for you at your various destinations, you know. Sri Lanka, too, I forgot. But you do have to bring maybe an Uzi, you know, bazooka even. Maybe bring two. But you can pack light. I mean, how much does an Uzi weigh? Not that much, right? And they have miniature ones for, you know, our little furry fellas here. Everybody must be armed. But that's just, you know, local culture. You want to be part of the local culture, which is very heavily, you know, that's very much part of the culture. But you'll see the excitement and the fun and just the enchantment that third world countries can bring. But first, the Lady Gaga stuff, okay? So here is Kai performing Edge of Glory on a certain radio program that we can't speak of because we don't have the right to mention that radio program because, you know, copyright, you know, restrictions and all that. So, but you can probably figure it out. All right, it's a beautiful song. Ready for it? Well, you already did it, but you ready? Okay. So here we go, people. Edge of Glory, not by Lady Gaga, but by her singing double. Yo, yo, yo. We'll be back after the song.
Gaga, go ahead, please. This is about your grandfather.
Yeah, it's about my
grandfather.
This
is the song that
and
came out of it.
You know, it's also about... it's about also knowing in your heart that you may never reach that glorious moment until you die. So... live life on the edge, you know, halfway between heaven and hell, and let's all dance in the middle in purgatory. There ain't no reason you and me should be alone tonight, yeah, baby. Night, yeah, baby. But I got a reason that you should take me home. To feel the rush, to brush the dangerous. I'm gonna run right to the edge with you, where we can both fall. another shot before we kiss the other side. Tonight, yeah, baby. That's about the tequila. I'm on the edge of something final. We call life tonight. All right, all right. Put on your shades, cause I'll be dancing in the flames tonight. To feel the rush, to brush the dangerous. I'm gonna run right to the edge with you, where we can both fall far in love. I'm on the edge of glory, and I'm hanging on a moment of truth.
You're already married. I have
Wow, that was good. That was beautiful. Holy, wait a second. No, no, don't. Sit right there for 1 second. Okay. I got to ask you something. That was beautiful.
Oh, thanks.
I really was moved, and you've got some voice. I mean, you're really an unbelievable performer, and that's one of the best live performances I've ever had on my show in all the years I've been here. Really.
Well, thank you so much.
So thank you for that.